inverse proportion. Now, when we change one quantity and the other quantity decreases, direct proportion is when one quantity increases, the other quantity also increases. But in inverse proportion, one quantity increases, the other quantity decreases. So two quantities may change like this. The number of worker, if they increase, the time taken to finish the job will decrease. Also, if you increase the speed, the time taken to cover a given distance decreases. Let us take an example. Zahida can go to her school in four different ways. She can walk, she can run, she can cycle, she can go by a car. So the speed of all these ways are given here in kilometer per an hour. 3 kilometer an hour, 6 kilometer an hour, 9:45. So as the speed increases, the time decreases, right? So what you are doing here is, this is 3. This is 3 by 30. Means if you take a ratio 3 by 30, that will be equal to 1 by 10. This is one of the ratio, right? Now, if you take this 6 by 15, what is this? 6 by 15, this is 3 to the 6, 3 by 15, this is 2 by 5, right? And this is also 1 by 10, this is 2 by 5. So, 1 by 10, if I multiply this by what number, so that I get this number, right? 3 by 30 is 1 by 10, 6 by 15 is 2 by 5. So, if you multiply 3 by 30 with half, what do you get? Multiply half, right? And you can also do one thing. You can see it in another way. Walking, if you multiply this 3 by 2, you get 6. If you multiply 30 by half, you get 15. Again, if you multiply 3 with 3, you get 9. And if you divide this 30 by 3, you get 10. So this is 2, this is 1 by 2. So if this is inverse 3, 1 by 3, this is reciprocal, or you can say inverse 15. 1 by 15, you multiply 2. So what I am trying to suggest here is, as speed increases, time taken to cover the same distance decreases. Zahida, when doubles her speed, the time reduces to half, and so on and so forth. So the multiplicative inverse here, that is, if 2 is a number, multiplicative inverse is 1 by 2, because when they are multiplied, it must give 1. So we'll take one more example. A school wanted to spend this much amount, 6,000, on mathematics book. How many books could be bought at rupees 40 each? Yeah, right? 150 books can be bought, right? Because for this is 6,000. And when you divide 6,000 by 40, you get 150. If the price of the textbook is more than 40, then the number of books could be purchased in the same amount of money would be less than 150. This is obvious. So if the price of book is 40, you get 150. How? 6,000 divided by 40. If the price of book is 50, now you divide 6,000 by 50, you get 120. Likewise. So what you have observed? You can say that as the price of book increases, the number of books that can be bought here, they are decreasing. They are decreasing, but the fund are constant. So ratio by which the price book increases when going from 40 to 50 is what? 40 by 50 is 4:5, right? This is 4:5. And the ratio in which the corresponding number of books decreases is 150 by 120, which is 5 by 4. So 4 by 5 is inverse of 5 by 4. That is, the two ratios are inverse of each other. So what one thing you would notice that once you multiply 50, let me give you. That means 40 into 150 will be equal to 50 into 120 because the price remains same. So you can say that when you multiply 40 into 150 and 50 into 120, you get 6,000. So here we have observed one thing, that the x into, if you take x as the cost of one book and y as the number of books bought, right? So as x increases, y decreases, and similar is the case for this. So x, y varies inversely with y, and y varies inversely with x. So the two quantities x and y, they are said to vary in inverse proportion, but x into y remains same. In this case, x into y remains always 6,000. K is always constant, and y1, y2 are the values of y corresponding to x1 and x2. So we can say x1, y1 will be equal to x2, y2, which is equal to k. And now the proportion becomes x1 by x2 will be equal to y2 by y1. x1 by x2 will be equal to y2 by y1. This is the inverse proportion. So in this example, the cost of book and number of books, the amount is fixed, they are inversely proportional. Similarly, if you take the example of speed of vehicle and time taken to cover the distance, they are in inverse proportion. So let us take some examples. Six pipes are required to fill a tank in 1 hour, 20 minutes. 1 hour is 60 minutes, 20, so 60 plus 20, 80 minutes. So 80 minutes. Six pipes are required to fill a tank in 80 minutes. How long will it take if only five pipes of the same types are used? So let us make a table, number of pipes and time. So six for six pipes, 80 minutes. For five, how much? Now these are in inverse relation. That is, lesser number of pipes, more time is required by or to fill the tank. So this is the case of inverse proportion. You can just do it. 80 into 6 will be equal to 5 into x, and you can find x by dividing this by 5. You get x equal to 96. And 96 is of course, because this question is asked or given in terms of 1 hour 20 minutes. So you can just convert it, 60 plus 36, that is 1 hour 36 minutes. There are 100 students in a hostel. Food provision for them is 20 days. How long will these provision last if 25 more students join the group? So we have a provision, say, you know, it lasts for y days. When the number of students is 125, just make a table. For 100, days are 20. For 125, we don't know what amount it is. But the food remains the same. So 100 into 120 will be equal to 125 into y, because they are in inverse proportion. You can find a y by dividing the multiplication of 120 by 125. You get y equal to 16. So there is another way also. X, you can just take the way I described you. X1 by 1 will be x2 y2 because the content remains same. So x1 by x2 will be equal to y2 by y1. Just put the value, you get again y equal to 16. If 15 workers can build a wall in 48 hours, so number of hours 48, number of workers 15. How many workers will be required to do the same work in 30 hours? So this is 30 hours, we don't know what is y. So 48 into 15 will be equal to 30 into y, because they are inverse proportion. More the number of workers, faster the wall will be built. So just divide this, 48 into 15 is equal to 30 by 30 into y, divide this much by 30, you get y equal to 24. So what we have discussed, two quantities x and y, they are in direct proportion. If they increase or decrease together in such a manner that the ratio of the corresponding value remain constant, that is x, y will be equal to k, then x and y are said to be varying directly. So in this case, if y1, y2 are the values of y corresponding to x1 and x2, the ratio will be x1, y1 will be x1, y1 will be equal to x2, y2. In the second case, two quantities x and y are said to be inverse proportion. If the increase in x causes proportional decrease in the y in such a manner, the product of their corresponding value remains constant, that is x into y will always be k constant. So x and y are said to vary inversely. So in this case, y1 and y2 are the value of y corresponding to x1, x2 and x respectively. So we can just say x1, y1 will be equal to x2, y2. So you can say x1 by y, x2 will be equal to y2 by y1. In this case, x1 by y1 equal to x2 by y2. In this case, x1 by x2 is equal to y2 by 1. So this is all.